All right, so first of all, thank you and welcome to new subscribers. And yes, if you subscribed because you were interested in a free reading, I just wanted to say, just a quick catch up before I do the reading, just a couple of quick announcements. First of all, I am going to be doing some more free readings, but they will be a competition. I'm going to do 2 free readings at the end of July, and I might make that a regular thing. So, I just thought it would be nice to do some readings that would allow me to reach more people, to help more people. So I've split these up in signs, so I'm doing readings for all signs and for the month of July. But what I'll do is I will look to see which of the videos has been the most popular, in other words, which ones received the most comments and likes and things like that. And then from that video, if everyone just makes sure that they comment under the video, when they comment they do mention whether or not they'd like to have a free reading. If you want to comment just for commenting, that's great, that's fine as well. But what I'll do is I will choose from the most popular video, I'll take all the names of people who've said they'd like a reading and I'll put them in a hat at the end of July, and then I will do 3 free readings which will be posted on the channel. So if you've looked at the free readings playlist and you've seen those, you'll see what I mean, you'll know what I'm talking about, and you could have one of those. Those are on display because they're completely free, and that was kind of the agreement. But if you do book a private reading, all the details are under the video in the description box. That is completely private. You get a completely private link sent to you, or it might be audio, or it might be on Skype. But either way, if you do book a reading with me, it is completely private. But if I do one of these giveaway things and you win a free reading, that will be posted on the channel. That's it. Thank you so much again for coming to watch the video, and I hope you have a fantastic July, and I'll speak to you soon. Hello, lovely Aries. So this is your reading, your Angelscope, Tarotscope, with a quick astrological overview for the month of July 2017. And first of all, so because the Sun and a few other planets are going to be in Cancer for most of the month, there is going to be a focus on that particular sign and its qualities for all of us, which are to do with caring, sensitivity, releasing the past. Sometimes it can mean, you know, that we've been holding on to the past too much and there's healing to be done in that respect. Sometimes it can be to do with childhood issues, and sometimes it's just to do with really, really taking good care of yourself. And for you, all the attention is going to be in the fourth house, because for you Cancer is on the fourth house cusp, so it's going to be all about home and family. So that kind of really ties in nicely, because obviously you're the first sign of the zodiac traditionally, so you know your fourth house, Cancer is the fourth house sign, and so you're going to feel that really, really strongly. So you're going to be thinking about how to really, really feel comfortable in your home, how to feel really, really good in your home again. So it's possible that you've experienced a few ups and downs in terms of your space recently, and that you're just beginning to settle back in again and to see how you can create a space that really nourishes and nurtures you and supports you in the next phase of your life, in the next chapters. Set your intentions about the sort of home environment you want to create and why that's so important for you, and any other things that you want to create around your home structure. So let's have a look. So we're going to do a Celtic cross first of all, and then we'll just pull some oracle cards. So we've got hope. Feeling very hopeful now, actually. Feeling very hopeful. And if you're not feeling hopeful, this is really a message from Spirit that to give you hope, to give you some encouragement after possibly a period of self-evaluation is the word that I'm hearing. Self-evaluation and sort of, well, what now? Where am I going to go? Where am I going to go now? Lots of endings. There have been a lot of endings for all of us. A lot of reappraising and reshuffling of all aspects of our lives so that we can come into the truest vision of who we are. And for you, this hope is crossed with emotional withdrawal, so you're still really kind of trying to go deep inside and take deep care of yourself. And I'm not going to say recover from trauma, but it does feel as if there has been a lot of sort of imbalance and a lot of sensitivity as well, you know, with that Cancerian energy. That's going to be heightened for you in the month of July, and especially around your home, wanting to really take care of yourself, wanting to really more than ever have a sanctuary, a place that you can retreat to that feels really safe and really good and nourishing for you. So what's above you? So try not to withdraw too much. It might be an important time for you to withdraw in order to then go out again into society. So take care and take all the time you need to do that, but don't become too isolated, because you've got here the potential to create partnerships and alliances that will help you to come back out for yourself and to restore your faith in, you know, where your faith has been wounded, let's just say, recently. So at the basis of all of this, a lot of planning going on, and the need for you to have patience and to get real clarity. So with every, what I'm hearing is that with every delay that you've experienced, with every time that there's been a need for you to be patient, you've learned something really important. So take each step as it comes. Don't try to run too fast or you'll trip. And not just that, because that sounds a bit ominous. It's not that, it's that you might miss something that would be really helpful to you in the future. Things are expanding and flowering in their own way, in their own perfection, in their own perfect time. And you can look back now and see that things that you wanted to open up quickly and to evolve in a particular way, maybe a few months ago, if they had done, you would have missed out on some of the lovely things that you're that are blossoming and developing now. So let's see, moving out of a phase of really trying very hard to balance yourself. You could have been doing some chakra work, because I've just heard chakras, but really trying to rebalance yourself, trying to ground yourself, trying to feel stable, not just in your home and your career, but also in yourself, in your body. And I'm being drawn to the 11 on this card, and I feel that for a lot of areas, there's been a lot of awakening, a lot of changes in their physical environment, the structure of their work, possibly things that are pointing out the way to a higher version of yourself and to the work that you really came here to do. And you're moving into a phase where you're being asked to be patient again, because there is a higher plan at work which contains things that you can't necessarily see exactly how amazing they are just yet. So it's a period that you're being asked not to see it as a trying thing. Don't see it as something that's difficult. Don't see yourself as being limited. Where things around you are not racing ahead as quickly as you'd like them to, it's because this patience and planning is needed to get it just right. And also the nurturing that you're doing at the moment and the emotional withdrawal are actually the things that are giving you that hope. They're allowing you to get strong again so that you can shine from within. You know, it's as if you've lost a little bit of your shine, and this time, this period, is bringing it all back. So, your attitude, wanting to regain authority over your life, that's how I see it, wanting to regain authority over your life, not wanting to feel controlled, not wanting to feel that anyone else has authority over you, wanting to take complete ownership in all respects, in all regards, ownership of your home space, feeling as if you are free to come and go, and as if you are able to, you know, keep be in command of all of the aspects of running a home and just being on top of things in terms of the structure of your life generally. Wanting to feel like you're your own person. I just heard really clearly, I'm my own person, I'm my own boss. It's that sort of energy. So, and in your environment, in your home environment, well, not necessarily your home environment, in your general environment at the moment, you're being asked to be aware of any kind of deception, any kind of envy, anything. The feeling that I've got with this is when you are hatching and planning things and coming up with new ideas, there is a period that is very sacred about that, where you're just building, you're building the plans and you're building the energy and you're building your manifestation. And I feel this is the warning to not be too vocal about what you're doing just yet, because I just feel as if there are maybe some energies around you that are just sort of watching you, like kind of watching to see, oh, well, what's she going to be doing now? Or what's he going to be coming up with next? And, you know, just, it's, I just think it would be so much nicer if everyone focused on what they were doing and put all that energy into what they were doing and creating. And we'd all just be so expanded and so incredible, because we all are. But unfortunately, sometimes people don't actually believe in themselves. And so they believe that it's easier to sort of pull everyone else down in order to make themselves feel less small, if you like. So just be aware of that. And just keep focusing inward on building this plan. And when I say focusing inward, that's not a contradiction. I'm still saying don't become too isolated. Focus inward in terms of building your strength, and make sure that when you share in the right direction. You do it with consciousness, with purpose, and with a view to gathering the right people and the right energies around you. Your hopes and fears. You're afraid that you're going to be defeated again. So the sense is that you've tried lots of things and, you know, you've been knocked down. I'm just hearing that Chumbawamba song, I get knocked down but I get up again. Get up again, you're not ever going to keep me down. It's a bit like that. It's like this person falling down the stairs and there's a sense of, oh my God, here we go again. Do not harbour those thoughts, because remember, you're creating your reality, and now more than ever, you have a sense of that, because we all do, because things are speeding up so much. It's, you know, it's practically tangible that we can see the results. So let's have a look at your outcome card, Aries. Wonderful, absolutely perfect. Right, so awareness, your awareness is growing, your awareness is developing, and through trial and error and through a period of lots of introspection and self-examination and all these changes that have been going on, you have become much more aware of when to speak and when to, you know, when to keep things to yourself, when to move, when to stop, when to go in this direction and when to go in that direction. So your awareness is growing all the time, and what the cards are saying is that you are about to go through yet another huge growth spurt in your awareness, and probably your psychic and intuitive development as well. And understand that that will bring you, oh, thank you, Spirit, that will bring you a lot of the answers that you're not seeing just yet. You'll be working in communion, in partnership with Spirit as well. So, and I'm being asked to pull one more card, okay, financial and material changes. Now that card, it can mean changes either way. What I feel for you is that this whole reading has been moving you towards this sense that it is possible. What you want to do is possible. Anything is possible, as long as you hold the right perception and as long as you don't self-sabotage by speaking at the wrong time to the wrong people in the wrong place and in the wrong way. So really, in a sense, this card is saying you can have it if you want it. Take it or leave it, it could go either way. There will be changes, and it depends on your awareness and what you decide to do with that awareness. One more truth. Okay, that's great. So you are about to discover the truth of many, many facets of your life that you were sort of aware of, but not completely clear about. They were just inklings that I get the feeling that I could try this and I could be really good at that and I could succeed at this, and that maybe this is where I need to share and that isn't. That's where I need to keep quiet. All of these things, it couldn't be better, really. Awareness, truth, the truth being exposed completely, and as a result you will be able to create much more abundance, much more prosperity, and feel much more the authority of your life. Okay, that's wonderful. So Aries, that's all for July. I'm going to have a quick look at past, present and future. And when I say future, it's what your highest potentiality is at this time as you move into July, through the month of July. So past, so you've recently broken free of something that was very restrictive. You were trying lots of new things as a result of breaking away. So it's like, break free, yay, I'm free, I'm going to do this, and I'm going to do that, and I'm going to do this, and I'm limitless and boundless. And it's almost as if you've sort of worn yourself out a little bit with doing all of that, because the energy behind it is almost like, you know, a catapult thing where you've been held back and held back and held back and held back and held back, and then you're released and you fly forward, but not necessarily with the focus, direction and clarity that you're going to have in the future when you develop this new awareness. And it brings everything down to a very precise pinpoint of, ah, this is exactly what I want to do. This is exactly what I feel is right. No more scattergun. No more throwing spaghetti at the wall. Okay, so, and seeing what sticks, you know, just real clarity. So this time of rest, that's absolutely right. It's absolutely right for you to be resting, recharging, and finding your glow again from inside. And the future, moving into the future, that's wonderful. Your prayers are manifesting. Remain positive and follow your guidance. So stay positive. Stay positive. Have faith. Have faith in yourself. Have faith in your journey. Things are working out absolutely perfectly in July. And I feel that that's going to mark a turning point for you when, yes, you will be resting, but you'll be starting to emerge from that and starting to see yourself as the creator again. Okay, have a great month, Aries, and good luck with everything. I'll see you next month. If you'd like to book a reading, the links are under the video. Take care. Bye.